The following video contains two creepy stories narrated by people who encountered these situations in real life. The second story would give you chills. Keep watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications for daily creepy videos. Story number one. About almost a decade and a half ago, I got an invitation to attend my cousin's dinner party. I had never seen my cousin before and only spoke to him on the phone. I was surprised that his family unexpectedly invited me after all these years. The invitation had an uncharted address that the GPS was unfamiliar with. I used a map and pinned its location. As I'm driving, I tend to notice how far I ventured off from civilization. Trees after trees, farms after farms. Where the hell am I going? I finally found a similar address that might be it. Approaching the house, I noticed how dull and dreary it looks. It's completely engulfed with leaves and branches. This can't be it, I said to myself. As soon as I entered the rocky driveway, my aunt and uncle came out to greet me. They seemed excited and welcoming. Walking into the house, I asked where my cousin is. Answering immediately, he went running a few errands. He should be back later. We spent the whole couple of hours talking about my mother and family. My aunt made a delicious homemade pot roast that I finished in minutes. After dinner, we played an enduring card game. It was surprisingly fun and competitive, and even interesting that time went by like a flash. When we finished the game, it was dark, and still, no sign of my cousin. Regardless, I had to leave. It was dark, and I would have trouble getting out of this dreadful place. My GPS was ineffective, so I asked my aunt and uncle for the correct and easiest way onto the highway so I can get back home. They gave me a puzzled look. We thought you were staying the night. I told them I couldn't because I had work tomorrow and couldn't afford to miss another day. It's much better if you leave tomorrow morning. Trust me, you'll get lost. I shrugged it off and told them not to worry, as I'm an adept navigator. I could get out of the Sahara Desert. Looking aggravated, they strongly advised me to stay the night for my own sake. At this point, I was getting pissed and irritable. I sighed. Fine, I'll stay the night, but I have to get up early for work and leave. Both of them seemed strangely ecstatic that I was staying there for the night. As soon as they went to get my bedsheets and pillows, I ran out the door and got in my car. I hastily pulled out of the driveway. It took me a while, but I found my way out of that depressing place. I got home an hour later than expected. It was 1 at night, and I didn't want to wake my parents up. I climbed my fence and entered the house through the back door. I noticed the kitchen lights were on. As soon as I took my first steps into the house, I saw my mom sitting there, looking impatient. "Where were you?" she asked. "I was at Aunt Deborah's. You knew this," I said. "Then why did she call, saying you never arrived?" she questioned. To this day, I have no idea who I visited that dreadful day. Story number two. We were staying in this fancy hotel for my cousin's wedding. It was 12. I woke up to a rough shove, assuming that my sister was waking me up. It was early morning, about 7:30. I groggily stepped out of the bed and was hit with hairspray fumes. I heard the sound of someone taking a shower, as well as loud, hurried footsteps and repetitive spritzes of the hairspray. I walked to the dresser and pulled out a blouse and a skirt. As I got dressed, I heard knocking on my door. I pulled my top fully on and opened the door. There was no one there. I was kind of freaked out right now, but I knew that it must be my imagination, as I was about half asleep at the time. I exited the bedroom. I heard the shower shut off as I passed the lavatory, then my father's heavy footsteps at the end of the hall. there was another restroom. I heard repetitive spritzes coming from there and called my mother. "Hey, Mom, I need to pee, and Dad's in the other bathroom." I heard my mother's voice. "Alrighty." It was her voice, but "alrighty" was not something she had ever said. I rolled my eyes and walked away. I figured that I should wake my grandfather, as I heard heavy snores coming from the room that he was sharing with my parents. I wondered why my parents hadn't woken him up. When I opened the door, I was scared to see that the room was empty. Just then, the noises and the smell of hairspray stopped. I ran downstairs and saw that my roommates, Dad, Mom, Grandfather, and Clarissa were already eating breakfast. I checked my watch and saw that it was already 10 o'clock. My mom stared at me. "What?" I thought. My sister then said, "What the heck?" I asked them what was wrong. My sister said, "You literally just went to the bathroom," and pointed to the lavatory next to the small kitchen area. I walked over there and pressed my ear to the door. Sure enough, someone was there, washing their hands. I shook it off and counted my fingers. 10 of them. I wasn't dreaming. I knocked on the door, and inside the bathroom, I heard my own voice calling out, "Alrighty." I looked over at my parents, sister, and granddad, who were all pale. Behind my back, I heard the lock click, followed by my own voice saying, "Hey there, Sarah," and footsteps. I turned around just in time to see my own feet, dressed in my black velvet flats, turning the corner on the staircase. I felt paralyzed with fear, and goosebumps crept up my back. I wasn't able to move for about a minute before I told my family all about what had happened a few moments ago. My sister told me that yesterday when she woke up, I wasn't in my bed, but she heard noises coming from the bathroom. When she went there, she saw me walking down the hall in my pajamas and called out to me, but I kept walking. When she went back to my room, I was still sleeping in my bed. She freaked out and didn't tell anyone.